family.
Say your cash is fair. You have a favorite line. Hello.
Well, hello, girl.
Oh,
isn't that cute? Hello.
Oh, my God.
I don't care.
Nobody got me, boy.
I'm sure my girlfriend got me now. Here you go.
You gonna have me
by? I have a plan. Wait.
I have a plan.
Mom, when you see this tape,
ain't that cute?
I didn't get anything.
That's what the three stands for. Same thing as these three stands for.
What does it stand for?
Ain't that sweet?
3 months, 3 years, 3 days, 3 hours.
Love.
You.
Oh, don't let me get your way.
Thank you.
Coordinators for Jamboree 1991. First is Miss Lynnia Perry. Lynnia, the daughter of Miss Mary Perry, is a sophomore interior design major from Orlando, Florida. Her activities at Faulkner University include being a member of the Pied Pipers for the past 3 years and serving as devotional chairman of the Tri Alpha Social Club. Lynnia was also a sophomore representative on the 1991 homecoming court. She also enjoys sketching, designing, and teaching children's Bible classes. Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Lynnia Perry. Our other student coordinator is Mr. Sam Wilcutt. Sam, son of Mr. and Mrs. Glenn Wilcutt, is a sophomore computer business administration major from Pensacola, Florida. His activities at Faulkner University include serving as student coordinator of the Ambassadors Club, treasurer of the Kappa Sigma Phi Social Club, and sophomore class president in the Student Government Association. He also enjoys traveling, fishing, and hunting. Well, ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Sam Wilcutt.
Seniors and students. We're enjoying our 14th year of Jamboree, where we brought back dragons from once upon a time, survived cannibals from yesterday once more, gone fishing in a country Jamboree, and rock and roll through the 50s. 14 years of great shows.
Every year, Jamboree is dedicated to a special person. This year, we have chosen a very special staff member who we feel greatly deserves this award. Much time has spent trying to find just the right person dedicate our Jamboree to. This year was no exception. This person is a strong supporter of Christian education. She is an alumna of Alabama Christian College, an employee at Faulkner University, and has 3 children enrolled at Alabama Christian Academy. Her career at Faulkner began in August of 1984 as Dr. Dan Lucas's secretary. In June of 1988, she became development records secretary, and in June of 1989, she was hired as Vice President David Short's personal secretary and is presently serving in this position. Brother Short stated that this person is an enthusiastic, totally committed person Faulkner University and the reason for its existence. To her, it's not just a job, it's a way of life. We need everyone at Faulkner University to have the dedication of this woman. Proverbs chapter 31 and verses 10 through 31 speaks of a woman who's dedicated to her family. This person is a devoted mother to her three children, as well as a dedicated sister to her Faulkner family. For her unending devotion and undying love for Faulkner University, we proudly dedicate Jamboree 1991 to Mrs. Cynthia Boswell. War, knowledge, love, poverty. These are just but some of the different aspects of the big picture of life. Jamboree 1991 is based on the big picture. This also consists of the different media used to portray these aspects, such as television, plays, and movies. And now, we would like to present to you Jamboree 1991, the big picture.
Metz Barnes, son of Mr. and Mrs. Rhett Barnes, is a sophomore Bible major from Crestview, Florida. He is the vice president of the Lambda Alpha Chi Social Club and was on the dean's list last semester. He enjoys all sports, playing the piano, reading, and singing. Well, ladies and gentlemen, please make welcome, singing Unchained Melody, Mr. Metz Barnes.
I've only good for
now, it's Zeta, Ada Theta, and Chi Alpha, in from A to Z.
We dropped out of school.
Hi. Hi.
Why is it you're messing his hair up?
You gotta fuck your head out, I can't see you.
You already said
it. We're gonna win again this year.
Thank you.
Mr. and Mrs. Ray Joiner is a sophomore pre-law major from Valdosta, Georgia. This is his second year to serve as a Jamboree host. He's also a member of the Zeta Eta Theta Social Club and enjoys hunting and fishing. Ladies and gentlemen, please make welcome Mr. Clint Joiner as he sings Love Without End.
Secret that my daddy said was just between
At this time, we'd like to introduce to you our Jamboree Tech Band, located upstairs behind where you are sitting. On backup vocals, we have first, Miss Jeannie Allen. Jeannie is the wife of Randy Allen and is the administrative assistant of Halcyon Terrace Methodist Retirement Community. Next to her, we have Miss Natasha Morris. Natasha is employed by Union Bank here in Montgomery and has a big date coming up May the 25th when she weds Mr. Brian Kastarjan. Running our sound this evening is Mr. Jim Morris. Mr. Morris is the minister for the Houston Park Church of Christ in Selma, Alabama. And finally tonight, we have Mr. Randy Allen. Randy is the assistant administrator of Halcyon Terrace Methodist Retirement Community, and this is his 8th year to serve as musical director for Jamboree. Ladies and gentlemen, let's have a big round of applause for the Jam Band of 1991. Cheerleader for the Faulkner University basketball team and is also a member of the Tri Alpha Social Club. Her hobbies include running and swimming. She also enjoys doing mission work in Central America during her summers. You better wise up. Here comes Miss Carla Cook.
Thank you.
life. You got to rise up. You got to. You got to.
It's Epsilon by Upsilon and Carrie-I, Nay-I in Hollywood Dreams.
Thank you.
stairs, girl. When I'm alone in my room, I set the stairs to wall.
And in the back of my mind, I hear my conscience call.
Telling me I need a girl as sweet as a dove.
And for the first time in my life, I see on his
yeah,
love.
Boy.
Yeah,
well, hello, darling.
We are the generation that you have.
Intermission. Please pick up the slime around your chairs. Welcome, Mr. Metz Barnes, as he sings the song For You. Alpha Chi and Alpha Delta Psi in Pictures of Broadway.
Gentlemen, I'm with us on a magical musical tour. it takes so much. This is fine and dandy, but this is the 90s. We got to kick the beat just a little bit harder. Yo, Nick.
What up, man?
You ready to kick the beat?
No, I'm with this.
Mr. Clint Joiner as he sings Unanswering Prayer. Thank you. Singing Good For Me.
Thank you.
now, welcome back our student coordinators as they present the Parent and Friend of the Year Awards.
The two most special.
The two most special people in almost everyone's lives are their parents and their friends. Every year at this time, we present a Parent of the Year and a Friend of the Year Award for someone who feels their parents or friends are special to them. First of all, we will present the Parent of the Year Award. While we as students are away from home at college, one thing we miss most are our parents. Sometimes we forget to appreciate our parents until we are away from home. Our parents are truly special because they love us so much and would do almost anything for us. Because of this love, we would like to recognize a special parent to be Parent of the Year. Here are the words of this year's recipient chosen to win the Parent of the Year Award.
To my parents, John, Diane, Amber, the best of parents, the most valuable gift I have ever received was the gift of loving parents. There are many children in the world today that have been born into a world of unhappiness due to the simple fact that their parents don't care enough to just love. But luckily, God has been me with a set of parents that love, care, give, listen, and that will put their lives down on the line for me. It takes all of a person has to give to take on the commitment of being parents. My parents are not only two people that have the responsibility of my well-being, they are also my best friends. To have a good relationship with your parents, one must realize that parents are human. They are not perfect. The phone calls, the letters, and I love yous are a simple little gift that mean the most that my parents give me. I wish I could repay them for doing a most wonderful job with me. But all the money and material items can never repay my parents for all they have given up and suffered. One day I pray I may raise my children the way I have been raised, giving my parents the opportunity to see their grandchildren with responsible and loving parents is one sure way I will repay them. My parents have listened to my opinions. They have stood up for me. But most of all, they have shown me the Christian way of life. If you were to ask 100 people about their parents, most of them are most likely to say that they are the most wonderful in the world. And I'm sure they are. But honestly, I can never ask for a more wonderful set of parents than mine. The parents that have raised me are not the same to as born me. However, all of my parents are and are the most wonderful people in my life. When I was 5 years old, my father got killed in a car accident. My mother was left to raise 3 children on her own, but only for a short time. She married me and brought into her little children's life a new father. It was the most greatest thing that could possibly happen to her. My stepfather had never been married before, and he and my mother never had children of their own. Instead, he raised and took care of our community. Together, my mother and stepfather had created an excellent set of parents. I sure wouldn't ask for any other step. Thanks, Mom and Dad, for the life you have given me. I love you.
Goes to Beth Upton and her parents, Ron and Diane.
Best friend fits that category.
There's something unique about our friendship. He is also my boyfriend. We do everything together. Sometimes we take walks in the park, or we go out to eat at country in our favorite restaurant. Or sometimes we just sit around and watch TV. Our relationship is truly based on our friendship. David and I are a team. We help each other out in every way. Just the other day, he washed my clothes for me when I had to work. And if I ever need someone to listen or just to show him a frown, he's always there. I think David has seen me at my worst. He's caught me in embarrassing situations. He has seen me cry and seen me fail to try again. I know that as long as David is around, I will get the second chance, even when the world turns their back on me. Last of all, I just want to say thank you to David. He has seen the other half of me and doesn't seem to know. He knows that I'm a picky eater. I love to buy new clothes and I get a little crazy sometimes. Okay, a lot. Without the security of David's handhold, I couldn't make it through the hard time. Thank you, David, for becoming a part of my life and being my very best friend.
Ladies and gentlemen, the print of the year goes to Mr. David Owens and Miss Julie Clark.
Proudly present the hosts and hostess.
I see.
that seasons are made for change, our lifetimes are made for years.
Our student coordinators as they award tonight's awards for the club who has won Jamboree.
Now the moment you've been waiting for. The third place winner of Jamboree 1991 is...
Award. This is what Faulkner is all about, to try to have the best Christian attitudes as possible. The second annual Christian Sportsmanship Award goes to Epsilon Phi Upsilon. Thank everyone for coming out this evening. We hope you have enjoyed Jamboree and that maybe it has influenced you in some way or another. We would like to take the time now to recognize in our audience this evening the president of Faulkner University, Dr. Billy D. Hillier, and his wife, Mrs. Kay Hillier. Our admissions staff, Odile Villarreal, Paul Harper, Mike Seal, Greg Terry, Janet Watts, Melinda Harrell, and especially Joey Wigan, the director of Jamboree. would also like to thank Campbell Formalware, Candlelight Florist, Southern Trails, and the Shirt Shack.
We'd also like to thank the directors of the Host and Hostesses, Randy and Jeannie Allen, Mr. Jim Morris for his sound system, Natasha Morris backup, lighting crew, Scott Floyd, Jeff North, Eric Hasten, and Tim Skelton, and also the stage managers, Stanley Mann, Patty Shim, Gina Brown, and all stage crew. We couldn't do it without you.
We'd also like to thank Ross Mitchell, our announcer for this evening. Especially thank all the high school seniors again for coming out this evening. It has been a tradition here at Faulkner University to close our show with the song, Shower the People. This exemplifies what Faulkner is all about, to shower the people with love. Ladies and gentlemen, we proudly present the host and hostess singing Shower the People.
You can play the game, you can act out the part, but you know it wasn't written for you. So tell me, how can you stand there with your broken heart, ashamed of playing the fool? One thing can lead to another, it doesn't take any sacrifice. Oh, father and mother, sister and brother, if it feels nice, don't think twice.
Oh, everybody sing that.
Shower the people with love and love. Show them the way that you feel. Things are gonna work out fine if you want it alone. What I'd like to say to you. Things are gonna work out fine.
Thank you.
Somewhere over.